Wait, I hear someone talking.
So Alfs become the new emperor.
The remaining Rogress have all fallen into his hands, it seems. He'll likely find the path to the Holy Land, as inscribed in the Meridian Bible. If that should happen, ozone pollution will only get worse.
He may be a child of Esau, but he's still just another pathetic common race child. Growing up in these ozone-polluted lands, it's no wonder he was led astray by Riel's law.
I too belong to that pathetic common race.
I thought you left that behind you. Without ozone, the people of the common race will all perish. But with the dragon gem you got from the divine race, you're safe as can be.
We had best turn our attention to eliminating the child of Esau.
It does seem that Lark has become suspicious of us. Our best option now is to take care of Alf and wait for a new child of Esau to appear.
I will use code control to brainwash Lark. If that fails, we can use some other means to dispatch him. What do you think?
All right.
I knew those two were in on something.
But what are they talking about? If we can't live without ozone, Imaginal's law isn't meant to save the human race after all.
I knew it.
What do you mean, Ryfia? Do you know something?
The humans that Imaginal speaks of, that may only refer to the divine race.
So the common race will all be killed.
That's crazy. There's only a handful of the divine race left. Over 90% of the people on this planet are common race.
So the divine race would become dominant. I never pieced it together before. But if this is true, we've got trouble.
Let's discuss this later. If we stay in Benetnasch any longer, who knows what'll happen. Let's get back to the lightship.
Yeah, before we get caught. Huh?
What? You think I didn't notice you eavesdropping on us?
You won't take us without a fight. Now we know. You were working together all along, weren't you? Once we tell the director about this...
The director...
Huh? What's so funny?
Our dear director... is not in office anymore.
She's left her disc behind, too.
What? What the?
When Batrachides was attacked by the Imperial Army, my subordinate killed her and took it back for us.
I'll never forgive you.
I never asked for your forgiveness. I don't need the likes of you. I'm just here to teach that disobedient little child of Esau how to behave properly.
It is only a child of Esau that can choose a law. You can't manipulate him that way.
As one of the divine race, you should agree to the manipulation of Lark's code. If we have the ability to control Lark, then our race can be saved.
But what about us? If you were part of the common race, then...
Do not concern yourself with me. Now, be the obedient little puppet you deserve to be.
Lark!
Ryfia!
I'm sorry, Lark. I didn't know about any of this.
Ah, Diva. Just look what you've done.
Heretic. I won't let you get away with this.
Lark, run back to the lightship.
Got it.
After them! They're getting away!
Ryfia isn't waking up! This must be that code control brainwashing they were talking about.
It's likely the same as Gula's curse.
So if we can analyze the code like we did before, we should be able to get her to wake up.
Unfortunately, the only person that can see which code was overwritten is the diva, Ryfia.
What the?
Lark! Look at Sima's dragon gem!
It's glowing!
If you want to save the diva, go to the ancient tower Zeifellt.
Lark, are you okay? You look like you're off in your own little world.
I heard Zima's voice. He said we must go to Zeifellt if we want to save Ryfia.
The tower where Papyrus Saga was? Is there something else there that can help us?
Well, we don't have any other leads. I guess we just have to trust Sima.
Saving those in need is the number one rule for a hero. If we're going to save Ryfia, I don't think we can afford to ignore any clues that come our way.
You're right. Let's get going.